Listen carefully. Already we discussed about the meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue in plants means those tissue having the totipotency or able to perform the cell division. On the other hand, we have the permanent tissue in plant. Permanent tissue contains those type of cell which are not able to perform the cell division. So this type of tissue lack of cell division or are not able to perform the cell division. Now, how the meristematic tissue is created? When the permanent tissue, when the meristematic tissue is storing the materials on the cell wall, and due to some storage activity, within the meristematic cell, some intercellular change will take place. Then the meristematic cell are lost the power of cell division and converting into a new type of tissue that known as a permanent tissue. So when the meristematic cell of the tissue starts storing materials on the cell wall, so the cell wall will become the thicker one as compared to the meristematic tissue. And due to some intercellular change means that some changes take place within the cell, may some storage activity take place. So the cell lost the power of division, of the cell division, and converting into a new tissue that known as a permanent tissue. Now, within the permanent tissue, cell may be the living or the non-living. Cell wall will be the thick or thickest. Vacuole wall may be present or absent. Protoplasm may be present or absent. All of the features of permanent tissue. Now, on the basis of cell size and shape and mode of function, permanent tissue are classified into two categories. The simple permanent tissue and the other hand, the complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue means combination of similar type of cell which performing the simple function, like providing the mechanical support, to the plant, or performing photosynthesis or the storing of food. This type of simple function will be performed this type of tissue that known as a simple permanent tissue. And simple permanent tissue generally are the three types: parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma. And on the other hand, complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue means combination of dissimilar cells performing the complex function in plant. What will be the complex function? That will be the transport of water in plants or the transport of food. This type of tissue are termed as a complex permanent tissue. Now we are going to discuss about the parenchyma or the simple permanent tissue. Within the simple permanent tissue, we are going to discuss about the parenchyma. When, suppose this is a cell of a meristematic tissue, or this is the diagram of a meristematic tissue. Suppose. Now we know that cell wall are storing the materials on layer by layer. So due to the storage of materials like hemicellulose, lignin, pectin, the cell wall became the thicker one. And due to some storage activity, may some intercellular changes take place. So materials will be stored on the cell wall, and due to the storage activity, may some intercellular changes are take place and converting into a new tissue that known as a parenchyma tissue. These are the parenchyma tissue. The maximum body parts of a plant are formed by this type of tissue. Now, how can we identify this type of tissue in plants? First point, all the cell will be the living. The cells of the parenchyma tissue will be the living. Cell wall are thicker than meristematic tissue because of storage activity. The cellular starts storing materials on the cell wall. Now, the vacuole present, may some intercellular space or the space between two cells. May the intercellular space present. Intercellular space present in parenchyma tissue. Now, different types of parenchyma will be present in plant. For an example, some parenchyma tissue contain the chloroplast. It means the green pigment containing organelles. They are termed as a chlorenchyma. So the green portion of the plant having a specialized parenchyma cell that known as a chlorenchyma, which help in the to perform the photosynthesis. Now the second one, some parenchyma can store the air. They are termed as a enchyma. It present in some aquatic plant, which provide the bouncy capacity for the floating on the water. The enchyma are the parenchyma which store the air. Some parenchyma may store the accessory materials. Idioblast. They are termed as a idioblast. Idioblast means the accessory materials containing parenchyma. Some parenchyma may store the water. They are termed as a succulent parenchyma. Just termed as a succulent parenchyma. Now, in the plant body, the outermost part of the plant body, every plant contains the single layer of parenchyma cell, which covers the plant body. Suppose this is the plant internal portion. The outermost layer of a plant are formed by a single layer of parenchyma cell. That's known as an epidermis, which act as a protective tissue in plants. Some parenchyma may present within the xylem, termed as a xylem parenchyma. Some parenchyma may present within the phloem, they are termed as a phloem parenchyma. Now, most of the body parts of a plant, including the leaves, root, or the flower, are containing this type of tissue. Now, what will be the function of a parenchyma tissue? Generally, parenchyma tissue known as food storage tissue. Why the parenchyma termed as a food storage tissue? Because due to the presence of the large vacuole, they can store the food. The storage activity will be take place within the vacuole. Clear? The second one, some parenchyma help in the photosynthesis. That is the chlorenchyma. Some parenchyma storing the air, which provides the bouncy capacity for floating on the water. Some parenchyma storing the accessory materials. Some parenchyma storing the water. All of the activity or all of the function of parenchyma. Clear? Now next, the chlorenchyma. When the parenchyma cell, this is a parenchyma cell, starts storing materials. Suppose this is a parenchyma cell. Start storing materials only in the corner part of the cell. And converting into a new tissue that known as a chlorenchyma tissue. Now chlorenchyma tissue. The features of chlorenchyma tissue. Cells will be the living. Vacuole will be the absent or present. The intercellular space will be the absent. And the collagenous tissue will be present in lip stop. This is the lip stop. Mid veins of a lip. Lip stop. In calyx, all of the region where the collagen tissue will be present. Generally, collagen will be found in a dicot plant, absent in monocot plant. What will be the dicot plant? Dicot plant or dicotyledon plant? Generally, if you observe the seed having the three parts. One is P muli, which developing the stem. Second one is radical, which developing the root. And third one is cotyledon, which means the seed leaves, which developing the leaves. If the seed having the single cotyledon, then it's a monocotyledon plant. For an example, that is the rice. If the seed having the two cotyledons, they are termed as a dicotyledon plant. Now, example of dicotyledon plant will be the mango. Now, what will be the function of collagen? Collagen by providing the elasticity to the branch. Providing the mechanical support to the plant. And third one, if the collagen is still containing the chloroplast, they can perform the photosynthesis. So these are the function. Now the next one is parenchyma. The dead and mechanical tissue in plant. Dead and mechanical tissue. Mechanical tissue in plant. They are termed as a parenchyma. So group of dead cells present in plant, they are termed as a parenchyma tissue. Now due to the excessive amount of storage, cell wall will be the thickest one. And due to the aging, the protoplasm will be lost. The cell without the protoplasm, it means it's a non-living cell. Only the thick cell wall will be the present. This is a thick cell wall. Now, this type of cell will be present within the plant. Only the dead cell or the group of dead cells will be present in the plant. They are termed as a parenchyma tissue. Now, this parenchyma tissue, the features of parenchyma tissue will be all the cell will be the dead. Protoplasm will be absent. Vacuole will be absent. No intercellular space, the gap between two cells will be the absent. Now this parenchyma tissue are classified into two categories. One is the parenchyma fiber, and another one is the sclerites. Parenchyma fiber means thin long tubular fiber having narrow lumen. Which are dead in nature, that known as a parenchyma fiber. Different size of separate cell which contain the hardest cell wall, they are termed as a sclerites. This cell are also will be the non-living. Now, the sclerites are termed as a stone cell because sclerites contain the hardest cell wall. which looks like the stone. Which looks like the stone. That's why sclerite termed as a stone cell. Now, different types of sclerenchyma fiber will be present. For example, in coconut, the sclerenchyma fiber will be present as surface fiber. Surface fiber. In coconut. Clear? Now, some sclerenchyma fiber will be associated with the xylem. They are termed as a xylem fiber. Some sclerenchyma fiber will be associated with the phloem. They are termed as a phloem fiber. What will be the function of sclerenchyma? Sclerenchyma are providing the mechanical support to the plant. Mechanical support to the plant. And the surface fiber prevents the seed dispersal in case of the coconut. So these are the simple permanent tissue. I think the revision class of the simple permanent tissue is completed. Now we are going to discuss about the complex permanent tissue. What is that? The xylem and the phloem. In a short term, xylem means the water transporting or conducting tissue in plant. The water conducting tissue in plants. Clear? Whereas the phloem means the food conducting tissue in plants. Generally, the four types of cell are combined to form the xylem or the phloem. In the cells of the xylem, the cells of the xylem, tracheids, vessels, xylem, parenchyma, or xylem, fiber. Whereas the cells of the phloem, C tube, companion cell, phloem, parenchyma. Phloem, fiber. Look, tracheids means long tubular cell which having the pointed ends, which are the dead in nature, and the peak spaces. Long tubular or elongated cell having the bordered cell wall and pointed ends. These are termed as a tracheid. These are termed as a tracheid. And vessels slightly smaller than the tracheids and containing the similar type of features except no sidebar or the no bordered cell wall. The living parenchyma cell will be associated with the xylem. They are termed as a xylem parenchyma. The dead sclerenchyma fiber will be associated with the xylem. They are termed as a xylem fiber. So these are the four types of cell which present within the xylem. Now next, phloem, seed tube, long tubular cell. Long tubular cell having the seed plates between the junction of two tubular cells. They are termed as a seed tube. Within the seed tube, the cytoplasm present, but absence of nucleus take place. So no nucleus, only the cytoplasm will be present within the seed tube. Clear? Now, on the seed plate, we have some pores. That comes as a seed pore. By using of this pore, the food materials will be transported. Now, each sip tube may associate at least one companion cell. Companion cells are those cells which are present around the sip tube and always help the sip tube to perform this function. Now, companion cell containing the are metabolically very active. Huge amount of mitochondria and ribosome present. Even the prominent nucleus will be present within the companion cell. Now, companion cell are always termed as a friend cell. Why the companion cell termed as a friend cell? Because this companion cell always associate with the sip tube and help the sip tube to perform its function. That's why the companion cell comes as a friend cell. Now, living parenchyma cell will be associated with the foreign, they are termed as a foreign parenchyma. And dead scleroderma fiber will be associated with the foreign, they are termed as a foreign fiber. So here, the first three elements, sip tube, companion cell and foreign parenchyma are the living. These three are the living. Whereas in xylem, tracheids, vessels, and xylem fiber are non-living. And function, foam will help to transport the food in plants. Now, ascent of sap. Generally, the transportation of water are quite upward by the help of xylem, that known as a ascent of sap. The root will absorb the water and this water are moved upwardly towards the leaves. This type of movement of water in plants, that known as a ascent of sap. The plant leaves performing photosynthesis. They are producing the food. Now this food are going to be transmitted in root of the leaves of the different parts. So the transportation of the food by the help of foam, it may be the upwardly, downwardly or laterally. This type of movement of food are termed as a translocation. So xylem help in the ascent of sap, whereas the foam help in the translocation. I think that's enough for the revision class. Now in our next period, we will discuss about the animal tissue.